Thank you very much to all the speakers so far, and I will end this webinar in terms of presentations today with a look towards a perspective from us in Velux on what's driving renovation and what is the role of renovation renovation passports. First, let me start by addressing the same issues that have already been addressed by Martin and Tine and before. There's really a need to look into existing buildings in terms of energy performance. They are not as good as they could, and they use a lot of energy. Another thing that was not talked about so much earlier, but which we also see as a very important driver for renovation, is health and health issues in buildings, where we see that a large fraction of the European population is actually living in damp and moldy buildings, which has potential health impacts. This kind of building nearly doubles the risk of developing asthma, and according to a piece of research by Fraunhofer IPP in Germany, 2.2 million Europeans have actually developed asthma from living in such a damp or moldy building. So there's definitely there's a high need for renovation, not only for improving energy efficiency, but also improving health in buildings. This is of course not just for the individual a big issue. It's also costly for society, and this is also coming out of the research by Fraunhofer IPP, where they determined that the costs for just asthma in Europe is asthma and COPD is actually 82 billion euros per year for all European governments in direct and indirect costs. So it's very expensive for society as well. So also therefore there should be a high say degree of motivation to look into this. We wanted to explore what drives renovation when you take the perspective of the house owner. And in 2016, that's last year, we published the Healthy Homes Barometer, where we had made interviews with approximately 14,000 Europeans from 14 different European countries on issues relating to health and home. And there's no time to go into all those details. You can find the publication on the internet, but I will show you these numbers, which are relevant for, say, discussing renovation and the drivers behind renovation. The many people we talked to told us that half of them had made changes to the home within the last 5 years. They pointed towards several drivers for renovation. 75% wished to reduce energy costs, so that that clearly shows energy as a driver. But almost just as many wanted to improve overall well-being, which generally meant better comfort in their home. So this was actually a driver which is just as important as saving energy, and I believe this is very important to keep in mind when discussing also renovation passports. This is an outcome of a Danish investigation. It's made by an organization called Bolius, which is a non-profit organization working for the interests of house owners. They do a yearly survey where they ask house owners many questions related to the house, and here is one question relating to the importance of indoor climate when buying a house. And here 86% rate that the indoor climate is very important or important when buying a new home. So also this survey shows that indoor climate is really an important parameter, not just for the house owners that already own a house, but also for new owners when looking for houses. So a good, healthy, comfortable indoor climate is really an asset for a house. And now switching to something else, which is I think also interesting in relation to renovation passports. This is a collaboration between five different companies and with more associated partners. It started in Denmark, but is now also being rolled out in other countries. It's a collaboration called Better Home, which is essentially a business model for energy renovation. The idea is to make it easier and get a better, more healthy, and better performing house. It's as I said, designed to make renovation easy, to offer concrete solutions, to ensure quality, and give an overview of funding. There are many barriers that has already also been discussed earlier in this webinar. When homeowners start to consider renovation, they have to consider which installer, what installers deliver good quality, what about financing, are there any subsidy schemes, is it a do-it-yourself solution, or is it an installer that should be involved, and should I involve a house counselor, and which one, who can I trust? So there are many barriers which actually we can see often prevents people from starting a renovation. So there was a question earlier in the webinar. So how can we make this renovation attractive as installing a kitchen? And this clearly shows that there are barriers. This also led to an investigation of motivations for energy refurbishment. And here, it's definitely clear that saving money and economy is very high on the agenda. That relates to energy performance. So better energy performance improves economy, that's clear. But next on the list is better comfort and indoor air quality. So that's really a very high driver as well for many of these house owners. Then there's future proofing of the house. Some have environmental considerations, satisfaction, and also sales price is drivers. But it's say improving the household economy and improving comfort, that's clearly number one and two. So what's how does it work? The Better Home is collaborating with a large network of installers and craftsmen. So there's a homepage. You log on to the homepage, you enter your address, and the system generates a set of information based on what is publicly available about your property. It makes an estimate of the energy performance of your house as it is now, makes an estimate of what you can save by doing energy improvements, and then it offers you to be contacted by a craftsman. And this is really very simple, and this is the step that many people do take. They trust the organization, and they trust that the craftsmen and installers involved in this deliver good quality. So when they have done this, they will get a few offers on improvement, and these are based on three packages, as you can see here. There's the energy package, the comfort package, and the deep renovation package. And yes, you can see there's definitely a large difference in the investment and also in the energy saving. Then there is an estimated increase in property value. And the experience so far is that very few take the energy package, and very few take the deep renovation, while most go for the comfort package. So that was a little bit about the Better Home Corporation, which I think could be interesting to look into also for people working with renovation passports. Another thing that that we can see when we are talking to stakeholders involved in renovation is that some of the schemes that exist already, like this Danish mandatory scheme, it's say building quality scheme that you have to go through when you're selling your house. These are not very inspirational. They will focus on, say, faults and errors in the house, and point out how to fix it. Where there seems to be a potential also in providing inspiration. So if if this was not just about, say, pointing out facts and errors and numbers, but also providing inspiration of, say, how could you improve your house in terms of comfort, then we believe that this could actually also make it more interesting for the house owners and might attract more to do investments in this. This is really about the crucial part to unlock these private investments and get people on board. So here's say daylight rendering just as an idea of how inspiration could be added to these schemes. Then as a last thing, let's also consider legislation where, as already mentioned in the webinar, the EPCs is one instrument, and you could consider if EPCs should be expanded to also include indoor comfort and health aspects. It might be worthwhile giving that a thought. To go back to the topic of renovation passports, then it's really crucial that it makes renovation easy, that it's designed to be a service for the homeowner, that it provides value for the homeowner, and then it should consider what really drives renovation. And as you can see from many of these surveys, it's energy savings, it's comfort, and it's health. And then as a last thing, make it inspirational and not just include the boring facts. So that was actually the end of my presentation. So I will give back the word to Alexander and have some time for a Q&A.